Hey everybody, today we're going to be looking at SAML and using SAML to authenticate with Entra ID on a FortiGate. If you're new here, I'm Gregabyte and I talk all things network and security, and right now I've been focusing a lot on FortiGate. Recently I was talking with a customer who's used SAML for their SSL VPN, but we're interested in enabling it for their security fabric. But right now they're utilizing the IDP feature and wanted to move that to an external IDP up in Entra ID. So they wanted to make that switch, but weren't certain how that was going to play out. I dug into some of the docs. It wasn't entirely clear, and I figured I had all the parts, so I'd put it together. And I want to take you along with me. When we were discussing this, a big thing that came in mind for this client, as well as myself, was how is it going to react if connection to SAML is down, say the internet just goes down, I need to get into the FortiGate locally. If I try to force everything up into SAML and have it be completely SSO seamless, how do I have that fall back if connection breaks? So I dug into that. We'll talk about that as well as how to just make things a little easier. For this, I'm using my FortiGate 60F and I'm running 7.2.8 on FortiOS. So I'm here inside of my 60F. I've got Security Fabric and Fabric Connectors open. I'm going to go to the Security Fabric Setup. And I don't have myself set up in any sort of Security Fabric, so I'll keep myself in standalone mode. And I'm going to go to Single Sign-On Settings. And we're going to be using Service Provider because we want to send it off to somebody else. So for SP address, I'm just going to leave this to my local IP address. You can add that to something else, but that's what I'm going to do. We're not going to use a certificate because Entra ID or Azure ID, doesn't use that. I am going to keep the normal login page, which is going to start me at the FortiGate, and I can show you the difference between that and the single sign-on as we go along. I will swap over super admin to admin no access. That is going to actually deny me access and require that somebody give me access after logging in for the first time. It's good for initial login. So that way we can kind of monitor that type of access. So within here, I can drop down my SP details and the IDP settings here. We are going to go custom. I'll have to import a certificate, and then we'll have to verify these different line items here. So I'm going to keep this open, and we'll swap over to Azure ID, Entra ID. We've got enterprise applications. We're going to start a new application. And I'm going to create my own application, and we'll just call this Azure SAML FortiGate Login. We'll hit create. So I'm just going to follow along here. We'll assign a user to this. Then we'll go to single sign-on. We'll select SAML. We'll edit this basic configuration. Add in the entity ID. The reply URL is going to be the ACS. The sign-on URL. And the sign-out. We'll hit save. Just in a little bit here, but we first want to add in a different attribute. So we'll add a new claim. That's going to be username. And this will be user.userPrincipalName. We'll save. And then we can go back. And the last thing we need to do inside of here is first, download the Base64 certificate. And then we're going to copy over this login URL, Entra identifier, and logout URL. And they're in a little bit of a different setup than what we've got in here. So I'll paste these in. The identifier. And the logout. And then for this certificate, we're going to have to import one. So we'll select the one we just downloaded. And import it. It'll first show up as just remote cert one or remote cert whatever number. And I'll show you in a second how to rename that. So we'll select it, select OK. And now that should be set up. So to test that out, we'll go over to my user account and we'll refresh this. So we see a sign in with Security Fabric or log in locally with username. So I can do either. I'm going to sign in with Security Fabric. I'm already logged in, so I didn't get any type of login page. Just got, hey, an SSO administrator account has been created for Greg at gregabyte.io. And it's got restricted access. It needs to get granted. So I'll select to sign out. I'll go back to my other window. If I go to System Administrators, I'll see that Greg at gregabyte.io has been created with admin no access. So we'll double click into him and change his access over to a super admin. And now that we've got that, we can swap back over. And if I try to log in with Security Fabric this time, I should get logged in and have full rights. All right, there we go. Got full access in. Now we'll change over the default login page from the normal FortiGate login to the single sign-on page. And if we hover over this little eye here, we'll see that that is going to be the normal login page with a SSO option or automatically redirect to the IDP's SSO login page. So we'll switch over to single sign-on, hit OK. And then we'll go back to our other window and refresh and get logged in. So now that I've gone to the IP address of my firewall, I get sent over here automatically. We'll select gregabyte.io. And again, I'm logged in, but I never saw a login page for Fortinet. So let's test out what happens when I'm logged out of the firewall, log into something else with Microsoft. We'll just go to office.com and then eventually go over to my FortiGate again and see what that process is like. So we can see that I never saw a login page. It automatically did the SAML magic in the background and got me access into the FortiGate automatically. So a big question for me when I was looking into this was, how is this going to react if and when the internet has outages? So I've switched it back to the normal login, which should always be fine because there's always that option to type in username. But we'll test that out first, and then we'll go back, flip it again back to single sign-on and see how it reacts. So we'll go and turn off my WAN 1. And now that I've lost access to the internet, let's go try and log in again. If we refresh this, we'll see, we still have the option to sign in with Security Fabric. If we select that, it's obviously going to spin here because we can't connect over there, which is what I would expect to happen. I'm more curious here as to what's going to happen when we re-enable the SSO login. Will it fall back to give you the option to log in locally? So if we go back to Security Fabric, edit this to be single sign-on, and select OK. Let's switch back over here. And attempt to log in. So we do see that if we try and log in with SAML, just through the IP address, it's going to try and push us over automatically. So your fallback option in this instance is to go to the IP address and slash login. If you're using a port, you'll still want to do that as well, but I've just got it on the default 443. That will give you the option to either still sign in via SAML or use a local username and password. So I'll use my fallback. And I can still get in, but that's why you would need to have some type of local login with a fallback, hopefully with that free FortiToken for MFA. So if I go and turn our internet back on, we'll have to give it a minute, I'm sure. But if I log out here and go back to the login page, let's see how that runs. So it looks like even when things are running fine, you can always fall back to the login page if you need to use a local username and password. Using the default as the SSO login is going to automatically push you over. That is going to create a much better user experience since you won't have to click more buttons, and it may just be a seamless process because you're already logged in. But it does run the risk that if you're in an instance where you've lost access to SAML or it breaks in some case, you're going to have to remember to fall back to the slash login page. All right, so the last thing I'm going to do is quick show you how to change the name on the certificate that you uploaded. And the reason I do this is because I, while testing this out, selected the wrong one because they were both named very similar names. And that obviously breaks things. So if we go over to System, Certificates, we'll see a whole bunch of different certificates, but down here under Remote Certificate, you'll see that we've got the Remote Cert 1, and it was Remote Cert 2 for the other one, but I have since renamed it to Azure SAML SSL VPN because I didn't want to get confused again. You'll notice though that we cannot actually edit the name of this certificate. So the way that we can do that is going to be in the CLI. If we do config VPN certificate remote, and we show, we can see the two different certs that we have here. What we can do is rename remote cert 1 to, and I'll name it Azure SAML admin login. So now we can see I have them defined as an SSL VPN certificate and the admin login certificate. And if I refresh this, we'll see that that has been renamed. And if we go check back inside of our Fabric setup, we'll see that it has renamed this certificate. So that's it. That's how you use SAML to log into your FortiGate and what to do if potentially your connection goes down. I've linked some helpful articles down below, so go check those out and let me know if there are use cases that I missed. Thanks again, and we'll see you soon.